Let's play a two octave, two major scale. You're gonna have to shift. You can put your instrument in rest position while you're pressing. Because now I'm gonna show you where you're gonna shift. That was one octave. I'm gonna shift on the A string to what position? Yep, third position. There was my second octave. I'm on the E string, I'm going to shift one more time to what position? I was already in third, so where do you think I'm going now? First, second, third, fourth,
fifth
position. But I've run out of finger, so I have to use my pinky twice. And then I scoot them back for F sharp. And then I'm gonna shift back to third position on the E string. And then first position on the A string. A three-story house. How many stories in your house? Yeah. So you're starting in first position, and then when you get to the A string, what position are you shifting to? Yeah, first you get to the third position floor, and then when you get to the E string, you're going to go all the way to fifth position, and see your fourth finger shifts up and shifts back down. Then you come back the same way you went up. Then you go all the way back to first position. So it's like you're in the basement of your house. You ready? Here we go. Here's the basement. Shifting to the red tick. Uh-huh. And then all the way back to first position. Face mommy this time. Okay? Go ahead and set yourself up. Okay? So you're going to start in the basement of your house.
Okay?
Let's go back. Positions, or do you want to do a helicopter video?
Yeah, I think I need to do a helicopter
video. Okay, Cleo, do you want to be the video person? You can set your instrument down. Oh, actually, I'll go ahead and play on your instrument. Okay, you want to be the helicopter?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is how we're going to practice our scale. And Mom, you can write down that she's going to practice her scale 3 times every day. So here's our 3-octave scale. Videotaping right on top of the fingerboard. Mm-hmm. And I got to that blue dot. You already have a dot that tells you where fifth position is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. Pinky scoots up to the note and back to the note. But I don't let these fingers go. Yeah, our thumb is underneath, mm-hmm. right? And your thumb has to kind of come underneath here. Because if he doesn't, if he stays here, then Pinky won't be able to reach. That's not fair. You want to do it one last time? One last time, all by yourself. See if you can play your 3-octave scale. Practice her 3-octave scale 3 times. Okay?
Yep.
Now, we're still doing reading out of this book. Mm-hmm. And when we finish this book, we'll graduate to another book. In the meantime, can you tell me what time signature we're in? 2-4. Mm-hmm. Means 2 beats in every measure. And the note that gets the beat is the quarter note, because there's a 4 in the bottom. So if you're marching to the beat and your bow is playing the rhythm, you're going to play A, A, sh, A, sh, A, 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 counting to what number? To the beat. I will keep the beat for you. Can you tell me the name of the first note?
C.
C. Yeah, C sharp. Ready, go. Or how far apart? A, and that's a?
A.
A, how far apart are they? Octave. One, two. To be playing without getting influenced by what she hears. It means your reading abilities are starting to catch up with your listening ability. Yeah, so you're on lesson 37. If you're doing this at home, try to do a page a day.
Mom, you can write that down.
Mm-hmm.
Read a page a day for reading, which would probably fall in the box that says study. Is there a box that says study?
Yeah, reading.
Yeah, there you go. So this is your piece, and your piece is called Concerto Number 2. And it's the? So I remember this way. 1, 2, 3. It's the first one in the book. It's Concerto Number 2, and it's the third movement. How many movements are in a concerto? Do you know that?
Three.
A concerto is like a chapter book. Do you read books with chapters?
Oh, yeah.
So a concerto is like a book with chapters, except it only has 3 chapters. Now, I made her a pretty big photocopy, so it's easier for her to read. And there's not a lot of markings in here, but notice the red markings here just mean that those fingers are together. Those are your half steps, okay? And this orange position means you're in what position? And then you go back to?
First.
And then you shift back to? And then first. And those are the only times you shift in the piece.
Okay.
So we're going to learn that section first. That section starts on what note? Can you tell me what note that starts on?
B. Wait, no, G.
Yeah, starts on G. Okay? So working in book 4 means that we practice the sections that give us the most trouble first. So, G, B, D, F, E, D. We're not going to play the double notes. We're just going to play the single notes. Okay, and I'm going to play along with you. And we're going to try to read each note by itself. So, that's a G, that's a B, that's a D. What is that going to sound like? Like a scale or an arpeggio?
Arpeggio.
Yeah, it's going to be an arpeggio. G, first finger there, and you're going to be magically in what position? What position are you in? Yeah. So this first finger is telling you you're going to play that note in third position. Okay, so can you play F, E, D again? F, E, D. Good. Can you do that again? Again. With one finger. Okay, so now we're going to keep going. And that third finger, what string do you think that third finger is on?
E.
Yeah, okay, so let's play F, E, D. Not yet. Let's go back and play F, E, D again. Don't shift. You're still in third position. Where are you going to put your third finger? 1. And shift back to first position. Place E. What do you think that's going to sound like?
A scale.
Are you sure? Arpeggio. Yeah, it's going to be another arpeggio. Yeah. So you know what's cool about this is that first it's 101, second time it's
201.
Yeah, first time first finger, second time second finger. Okay, so can you play 201 again? Two. First position. 201. Good. Do that again. 201. Last time by yourself. 201. And that third finger is going to be on what string?
E.
Yeah. So play 201. 201. From measure 84 to measure 93. How old is Cleo?
9.
Ooh, I like that number.
Just for now.
Okay. So we're learning the notes because adding the double bows is easiest. Right? It's like when you learned. You learned the notes, and then after that, all you had to do was play. So that's what we're doing. We're just learning the notes because after that, you'll just make your bow go bump, bump, bump. Here we go again. We're going to play all the way through again. Nope. Just the notes. Let's learn the notes first. G, E, what is it? An arpeggio starting on what note?
G.
G, E, D. Natural. Where is F natural on your E string? On the tape or behind the tape?
Behind the tape.
Yeah, yes, behind the tape. Okay, try again. G, B, D, F, E, D, C, A, G, E, D, C. Open A. Ooh, what's that? Yeah, that's a C sharp, which is different than what you played earlier. Open A, C sharp, open E. Third finger shifts back down, right?
Yeah.
Now notice that you played an F natural here. He's not natural in this key. Do you know what key you're in? You're in the key of G major, which only has one sharp. What's the name of the one sharp in the key of G?
C sharp.
Try again. What line is that sharp on?
Oh, sharp.
Yes! Your note that's always sharp is F sharp. Your first finger on the E string is supposed to always play F sharp. But here they want you to play F natural. Okay, so we're going to hear that again. But this time you get to play it by yourself. G, B, D, F natural. Go. Whoops. Okay, so now, can you divide 9 by the number 3?
Yes.
How many is it?
3
times 3 is 9. So mom's going to write down 3 times single, 3 times double, 3 times single, 3 times double, 3 times single. You're going to go back and forth. You just did it 3 times single. You've already done your 3 repetitions with staccato. Okay, so now you're going to play the notes, but we're playing each note twice. So it's like a double, double, double. Yeah, your 4th finger's playing.
Beep,
beep. Okay, so play your D again. Play the D first. Shift up. First note, because you're in the key of
G. A little bit more attention, so when you get there with your piece, your fingers know what to do. That's what we did with the Beethoven one and book 2.
Yeah, you remember. Nice job. Those are my strategies to help you be successful. Okay, so you've already done it 3 times staccato and you've done it 2 times double. You need to do it 1 more time double. Double. That's the first note.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, A. Okay, so pick your team. Do you want to be single or double?
Single.
Okay, you're a single, I'm double. Are you ready? Yeah, oh yeah. You can do it. Okay, we're playing the same notes, but you're single and I'm double. Ready, go. Do you want mommy to videotape you?
Sure.
Okay, tell mom how you're gonna videotape. Are you gonna be single or double?
Okay, double.
Okay, she's playing what's on the page. She's literally playing this last nine. This is how many times you played it today. See? Oh, Laszlo's videotaping.
Okay, no. Okay.
I don't know if he knows his angle. Because she needs to be watching the music. So, mom, can you guide him to where he needs to be? Yeah? Okay. Do you have a good angle, Nesla?
Yeah.
Okay. So, here we go. We're going to start recording. 3, 2, 1. Yourself, remember when you see this A, you're gonna play an octave. Got it? Okay, this is your section. You're gonna practice it 9 times. Just the notes. You can do 3 plus 3 plus 3, or you can do 4 plus 5, or you can do, I don't know, 6 plus 3, or 9 plus 1. But you want to give yourself a chance to practice it both ways. And then your fingers will have many different ways of remembering what to do. and your muscle memory will start to build. Got it? Yeah, because even though you could probably play it by ear, you have to know what finger to play now because you're in the third position. Okay, so we did Bach Beret for the recital, three octave scale, reading, and our official book four piece, which is not really a fancy name. It's just concerto number
two and G major.
Third movement. It's kind of a boring.